Shout out to the livest audience here at Elizabeth City State University. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. This is Fame TV. I am one of your hosts, JP, and this is the lovely lady,
Arnice,
Alan Thomas,
and Val Marie.
Val, while we have you talking, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Okay, well, again, my name is Val Marie. I'm from Whiteville, North Carolina. I'm a double major in aviation science and mass communications with two minors in public administration and media studies. And I definitely have two radio shows at WRVS 89.9 ECSU. So y'all can check me out on Monday nights and Wednesday nights.
All right.
That's a good thing. And cool, Mr. Girl. Alan Thomas.
Yes, yes.
Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Alan Thomas from Elizabeth City, North Carolina. I was out here at Mr. ECSU 2007, 2008. Double major in accounting and business administration, concentration in management. And while I was out here, I also won Mr. Talent for the Mr. HBCU competition.
That sounds like you have a lot of accreditation.
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit?
I'm accredited.
Okay. All Ooh, right.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Hey, Miss Arnice, tell us a little bit about yourself.
All right. I'm from Washington, D.C. I'm a junior majoring in mass communications with a concentration in public relations with a minor in music. And I do a little bit of everything, so.
You do a little bit of everything?
on campus.
Do you sing?
A little bit.
Don't you want to sing for us?
No.
You sure?
No, I'm good.
You good?
I'm good.
Well, how about you, JP?
Right. What about you?
Tell us about yourself.
Well, my name is Jeremy Perkett. I'm from Elizabeth City, North Carolina. I attend Elizabeth City State University, an English major with a concentration in mass communications. I was Mr. Freshman in 2006, I believe. No, 2010, I'm sorry.
You gotta ask me how long you've been.
I was on
Boy,
SGA,
right.
You
professional know? Student?
Yeah, I was a professional student, that's right. You know, I took summer classes before I came out here while I was in high school.
Okay.
I wanted to get ahead of myself.
Okay.
All right. Well, thank you for tuning in. This is the first segment episode of Fame TV.
Yes.
We're gonna be talking about recruitment, a little bit about Elizabeth City State University. We're gonna bring in a couple of guests.
Right.
Tesla Becton will be in the house, as well as Mr. Darius York. Yeah,
William Smith.
Mr.
Dr.
William Smith.
Right.
Dr.
Ms. Houston Black.
And Ms. Mm-hmm. Houston Black. That's mama. That's mama.
Yes, mama.
That's mama Houston Black. We want you to make sure you stay tuned. Make sure you take some notes. We're getting ready to go into the segment of recruitment.
Good morning, and welcome to Fame TV. First of all, hats off to the Office of Student Life and to our students for creating this innovative idea to showcase, to promote and highlight Elizabeth City State University. I've had many opportunities over the past several months to talk with various groups, and my message has been the same. ECSU is alive and well. We are standing tall and walking proudly. ECSU has a rich history and legacy, but despite all of the wonderful things that have happened in the past, we must do more in the future. Our motto, to live is to learn, is something we fully understand. It must be lived, not just lined. It must be practiced, not just proclaimed. It must be fervently ingrained, not just fancied or favored. Here, not only are we working on campus to strengthen our relationships with students and the faculty, we are also working in the community to strengthen our relationship with local officials, with our area high schools and community colleges, and also with the Coast Guard. We have been given the challenge of serving as the educational provider for one of the most geographically challenging and economically disadvantaged regions in the state. We must ensure that those in our region who want to pursue higher education have a chance not only to tap into our resources, but also to pursue their goal of leading a successful life. The welfare of our great university is the object to which our care and efforts ought to be directed. Here, it's all about Viking pride. Viking pride. Viking pride amplified, beautified, dignified, fortified, glorified, magnified, and personified.
Greetings. I am Priscilla Zagla, the 2013-2014 Student Government President under the Run ECSU Administration. representing the student body through respecting, understanding, and navigating each other. A lot of people say that they would never imagine themselves being in the position that they are. But the truth is, I have always imagined myself being in this position. Elizabeth City State University prepared me for that. I was born in Italy to African parents who loved to travel, and they settled in America because they wanted to prepare better opportunities for me and my siblings. Elizabeth City State University prepared me to be the leader that I am, and I have learned how to get out of my comfortable zone with Elizabeth City State preparing me. Truth is, I admire Elizabeth City State University for preparing me for being in this position. And now that I am in this position, in my junior year, I can say that after graduating, I'll be able to take this out further and be successful.
Nice shot. Let's see what you can do now. Let's go, girl. How much do you want it? Brittany, what? Who's got next?
Hello, I bring you greetings from the Harbor of Hospitality. I am Heather Smith, Miss Elizabeth City State University 2011-2012. I am a senior from Beaufort, North Carolina, majoring in elementary education with a concentration in mathematics. I want to extend a congratulations to the CIAA for their 100 years of excellence. In closing, I want to thank Food Lion for sponsoring this year's Miss CIAA Food Lion Scholarship Pageant.
Welcome back, Fame TV. I'm Alan Thomas, and I have my bowtie brother with me, Myron Burnett. How you doing, man?
Good, Alan. How you doing?
All right, I'm good. What is your position out here?
I'm currently serving as Interim Director of Admissions for ECSU, and so happy to be here in Viking Nation.
All right. Now, can you give a little brief history on your background and where you come from?
I'm originally from North Carolina, Columbus County, so on the southeastern coast. I'm an HBCU graduate. From that time, I've spent about 12 years in college admissions and enrollment management, and just happy to be here with the Viking family.
That's good. So he has experience, ladies and gentlemen. What special recruitment initiative are taking place here?
We have two initiatives that we're really excited about for the spring that we want everyone to know about in the Viking family. One is our student receptions that we have partnered with the National Alumni Association to host at different cities around North Carolina and even some out of state.
Okay.
So we hope that students will go to our website, find out those dates, and attend those receptions. It'll give them a chance to talk with faculty, students, and alumni.
Okay.
So we're really excited about those. The other initiative is for current students here at the university. We want to send them back to their high schools during spring break. We call it Alternative Spring Break Initiative.
Okay.
And so we want students to go back to their high schools, identify and recruit students to bring to ECSU or to encourage to apply and consider us as an option for college. So we're really excited about those two events coming up.
That's awesome, man. Some fresh and new ideas coming, man. I never heard of that, but that's very good initiative. So.
Yeah, we're excited.
Right. How do prospective students get in contact with your office?
Well, obviously you can visit the website to contact us. We do conduct tours every day, Monday through Friday. You also can call us. But we really want students to jump onto our social media options, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. We have every mechanism available to students for them to conveniently communicate with us and stay in contact with what's going on.
All right. If you're in high school, middle school, even elementary school, go to the website right now, www.ecsu.edu. Check us out, give us a chance, and you won't be disappointed. Ladies and gentlemen, Myron Burnett.
I'm here with the assistant director of the admissions office, Mr. Darius Ure. Welcome, Mr. Darius Ure. How are you doing today?
Hello, I'm doing well, and it's great to be here today.
That's good. Well, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, as you stated, my name is Darius Ure, and I serve as Assistant Director of Admissions here at Elizabeth City State University, and I'm also an alumni of ECSU.
Okay. All right. Well, we're going to ask you a few questions for some people that may be curious about Elizabeth City State University. What are some admission requirements to ECSU?
Well, the admissions requirements are fairly simple to be admitted to Elizabeth City State University. If you're a high school student, you must have a minimum GPA of a 2.5, an SAT of an 800, and you must also meet minimum course requirements that you can read more about on our website.
Okay. All right, so take note, make sure you have a 2.5 GPA and also an 800 SAT score. Another question for you, Mr. Yura.
Yes.
What are some majors ECSU has to offer, just in case I'm undecisive?
Well, at Elizabeth City State, our majors range from mathematics, computer science, English, even aviation science. Why? We also have two airplanes that the university uses in our aviation science program as well.
So that sounds like aviation is a major thing at Elizabeth City State University.
It definitely is. We're the only four-year public school to offer aviation science in the state of North Carolina.
That's amazing. So after knowing what are the admission requirements and knowing some majors, how do I apply to Elizabeth City State University?
In order to apply, you can submit your application online.
Okay.
Also send in a copy of your high school transcript as well as your SAT or ACT scores and your $30 application fee.
$30 application fee. Make sure you take note. Make sure you apply online at www.ecsu.edu. For more information, contact Mr. Darius Ure or the Office of Admissions. Thank you.
Good evening. Wade Batilla here, head football coach, Elizabeth City State University. I'm here today with one of my top recruits who's visiting the ECSU on today.
I'm Derek Bailey. I'm from Surrey County High. My primary position is quarterback.
I'm recruiting to come in on the defensive side of the ball, preferably strong safety. But of course, you know, we always know the academic is first, so we can get here and get him signed and get him started for the next 4 years as a true Viking.
I'm a proud 2008 graduate of this illustrious university. And today I have my SGA president from Ronald Chuan Community College, who is planning to transfer here in the fall of 2014.
My name is Kenesha Gillum, and I represent Ronald Chuan Community College as your SGA president, and I will be transferring to Elizabeth City State University.
Welcome to Elizabeth City State University. You can't find a better place for affordability, academics, and atmosphere.
Hello, I'm Jeanette Evans, president of the National Alumni Association.
And I'm Barbara Sutton, the director of alumni relations here at Elizabeth City State University, class of 1974.
I'm the class of 1963, and it is my pleasure to say hello to all the Vikings out there nationwide, worldwide as a matter of fact. We hope that you will use this as an opportunity to hear and see more about us. We represent 20,000 alumni worldwide and 13 chapters nationwide. Welcome to Viking Land, and we hope to see you real soon at ECSU.
Welcome back to Fame TV. We are here with Mr. Ure again, who will be giving us a little insight on financial aid. How you doing, Mr. Ure?
I'm doing well. How you doing?
All right. Now, Mr. Ure, how do I apply for financial aid?
In order to apply for financial aid, you would just go online and complete your free application for federal student aid at www.fafsa.ed.gov. It is imperative that you use this by March 1st, which is the priority deadline for Elizabeth City State University.
Yes, that is true. Now, what type of aid are available?
Here at Elizabeth City State University, as you know, that over 90% of our students receive some form of financial aid. We offer scholarships, grants, work study, as well as student loans.
I didn't know about that. I need to do that myself. So how do I check my ECSU financial aid status if I do apply for financial aid?
To check your financial aid status, you just go to the homepage for Elizabeth City State University. At the top, click on Banner and log into SSB, and you'll be able to check all of your financial aid information right there, including your award letter as well as missing documents. So be sure to go to fafsa.ed.gov to complete your financial aid, as well as to ecsu.edu to check the status of your financial aid.
Thank you again, Mr. Yure, for coming out.
Thank you.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Fame TV. Today we have a very special guest with us, Dr. Gerald McCants. Dr. McCants, would you mind telling us a little bit about yourself?
Well, I'm currently the Interim Vice Chancellor for Student Affairs at the university here. Formerly the Chief Student Affairs Officer for the University of North Carolina General Administration, and I've been in this field now for about 40 years.
Okay. So, as the Vice Chancellor, the Interim Vice Chancellor, why would students want to come to ECSU?
Well, first and foremost, we have a real friendly student body. We also have an active student life here. We have a rigorous academic program. We provide individual support for our students. We also have individual attention that we provide to our students. They'll find that this environment, while it's small, also provides an opportunity to interact with administrators and faculty and other individuals who come to the campus.
Okay, and what organizations do we have on campus that would allow students to exemplify their leadership capabilities?
Well, we have approximately 65 organizations on campus, and those organizations are such where males and females can provide an opportunity for leadership. The unique thing about, for example, our Student Government Association, every position in the Student Government Association is held by a female. So they've gone through the glass ceiling, and it provides an opportunity to not only to be on our Board of Trustees, but as the president of the Student Government Association is, but it also provides an opportunity for our students to take out of the classroom into the practical environment those fundamentals of leadership.
Not only does students look for a safe environment to attend a university, but parents also look for safe environments for their sons and daughters. So what type of environment does ECSU provide for their students?
Well, we provide a safe environment for our students, one that is based upon the principle that your safety, your parents' concern for your safety, is foremost in our eyesight and our focus and our direction. So they will find a safe environment. They will find one that is, as I said before, an active environment. And of course, as we always attempt to teach our students in terms of leadership skills, the first protection starts with self-protection.
Okay, well, there you have it. Thank you for joining us at Fame TV. Welcome back to Fame TV, and today we have another very special guest, the Dean of Student Life and Judicial Affairs, Ms. Barbana Houston Black. And as always, you're looking very stunning today. How are you?
Thank you, and I'm fine. And it's a great day to be a Viking.
Yes, it is. And could you please tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yes, of course, I'm the Dean of Students. Prior to that, I've worked at Elizabeth City State for 14 years in the position as Director of Alumni Relations, the Associate Vice Chancellor for Student Affairs, and Associate Director of Admissions, and I serve as the Dean of Students.
Thank you. And I know there are four areas that you are head over. Specifically, we want to first focus on student life and residence life. Could you please elaborate on those two areas?
Certainly. I believe in the Maslow theory of hierarchy that makes sure that persons are fed well, that make sure they have a place to stay, and also make sure they have a good time while getting a great education at Elizabeth City State University. So residence life, we have over 11 dorms that you can choose to live in, and each of them have their own personality, so you just have to go online, check them out, and decide where you want to stay. Student life, we make sure that you have a wonderful time. We have great concerts, we have great events, we have over 65 clubs and organizations that you can be a part of. We also have Greek life, we have the bowling center, theater on campus, our student center. Take advantage of those opportunities that we have to offer in student life.
And also judicial affairs, I know you definitely work with that area as well. Could you elaborate on that for us too?
Certainly. On every campus we have great students, and then we have students that get in trouble. And I always tell them I'm like the mom on campus. I make sure you have a great time. But also, if you do something that you're not supposed to without following the policies and procedures of our university, then I will have to punish you. So sanctions are available. Hopefully that we have very few of those cases on campus, so judicial affairs make sure that you follow the policies and procedures that are located in your student handbook. You also can find them on our website under Students' Rights and Responsibilities. And anywhere on campus, you can find those the policies. We do have a system that we use, MyCent software, that keep account of all the sanctions, all the judicial things, our incident reporting forms, which are for students as well. If you have an incident on campus, someone harm you, please make sure that you go online to www.ecsu.edu, fill out this incident reporting form, which you can find under Students' Rights and Responsibilities under current student, future student, faculty, and staff. So make sure you fill out that form. It will come directly to my mailbox, and we are be glad to take care of any incidents that happen on campus. We make sure that this campus is safe, make sure that our students follow the policies and procedure.
Thank you so much for that information. But my personal favorite area that you cover is the Lyceum series. And I know we have some upcoming events for this semester. Could you please tell us a little bit about those events?
We have two wonderful events. One will happen next Friday, the Lulu Washington Dance Theater, all the way from California. We'll be performing in this auditorium. And we would love for all of our students, faculty, staff, and the community to come out and join us. Following that, March 28th, we will have the Virginia Stage Company, which will be doing the Shrew, Taming of the Shrew. So please come out. Tickets are on sale, $6 for students, $11 for faculty, staff, and the community.
Thank you so much for joining us, Ms. Houston Black, and we hope you enjoy.
Said this school was dead, like the cemetery it's built on. But we call our East Side teams ghosts, don't we? And what are ghosts? Ghosts are spirits that rise from the dead. I want you to be my ghosts. You are going to lead our resurrection.
Welcome back, Fame TV. I'm Alan Thomas. I have a very special guest with me today, Mr. William Smith. How you doing today?
Fine, Alan. How you doing?
All right, I'm wonderful. For those who may not know, can you let our audience know what is your position and what do your department do?
I am the Vice Chancellor for Institutional Advancement here at ECSU. My division is responsible for all the fundraising activities on the campus of ECSU. In addition to that, we are also involved with the Alumni Association, the University Relations and Marketing, and radio and TV services as well.
That's awesome, awesome. Why is it important to give back to ECSU?
Alan, over 90% of the students here at ECSU are on some type of financial aid. The external funds that we bring in to help our students continue their education at ECSU is very important. We get money from alumni, from foundations and corporations. Again, these funds help our students to complete their education here at ECSU.
How do I give back as a student or reconnect back to the university?
As a student, you can give by joining the Pre-Alumni Club. The Pre-Alumni Club is a club here at ECSU that will help students to learn how to give at an early stage in their academic careers. Also, we are rolling out a new text to give program in a few months that will allow students to give by using their cell phones as well. And as always, you can always give online through ECSU online. As an alumni, what you can do, you can become active in the ECSU Alumni Association. You can join one of the 35 chapters nationwide in the Alumni Association. You can also participate in the Chancellor CIAA Breakfast every year at the CIAA Tournament. We have our Founders Day Gala, which we give over $345,000 over the last 5 years for scholarships for ECSU students. This is a way that you can give back to ECSU and also become fully engaged with ECSU and help students complete their education here at ECSU.
Thank you, sir. Please give back to the university. We really need every little bit helps. It was $5, $10. You may not think it's a lot, but it is helping back to the university.
And Alan, we need young alumni to give back to ECSU and get involved.
Right. Young alumni, please give back. I'm gonna pledge $10 today. All right, I want y'all to match it, okay? Ladies and gentlemen, y'all give it up for Mr. William Smith.
Welcome back from the commercial break. We thank you for tuning in. This concludes our segment of recruitment. We'd like to thank Chancellor Becton for stopping in. We also thank Darius Ure. We also thank Mr.
William
and
Ms. Houston Black.
Dr. McCants and Ms. Houston Black. And we want to make sure you apply to www.ecsu.edu. Once again, make sure you go online and apply at www.ecsu.edu.
And don't forget to join us for our next episode, episode 2, Viking Fest Edition.
Viking Pride!
Viking Pride!